watch.
Rehearsals are going well, but I need a little help bringing this to life. I just feel like we're missing something.
No problem.
As I mentioned on the phone, this year's pageant is called Prince of Peace. I especially want the nativity scene to highlight this concept.
Prince of Peace. Got it.
Cast. Thank you for getting this vision so quickly. One announcement. I've invited a colleague of mine, Mrs. Johnson, to help direct rehearsals tonight. She's gonna give us a few pointers. You know, help spruce things up a little. You know, spruce? Like the Christmas trees?
Tough crowd.
Yeah, let's just start from the top.
Let us see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. This is the—
Cut! Try that line again, but I need you to remember that a host of angels has just appeared to you and sent you here.
Let us see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. This is the—
What I want is more excitement.
Let us see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. This is the—
I was thinking more on the lines of out of breath.
Out of breath? Why would I be out of breath?
Because you've been running. Think about it. A host of angels has just appeared to you and sent you here. I'd run if that happened. And you shouldn't be the only shepherd talking. Aren't you both excited?
Yeah.
Woohoo!
That's our savior. Yeah. Yeah.
Better. Dirt and some grass stains will help, but work on costumes later. Animals, you need to be making noise. There's commotion all around you, and your sleep is being disturbed by a newborn. You're not taking this lying down. Well, some of you might. You're not happy about it. Better. Now, Mary, you look perfect. Honey, that's not a compliment. You just walked 60 miles uphill on a donkey and had a baby. I don't think you're concerned with your hair. Joseph, very suave. However, you're exhausted. You're caring for your wife and trying to keep a bunch of animals away from your baby and probably trying to find a bunch of other accommodation.
Okay.
Wise men, chronologically, you're not supposed to be here for another couple of years. And,
he's on the shrine.
We'll go with it. You found the newborn king, but he's warning you not. You found the newborn king, and you know how Herod's gonna take it. You not to back it. You're in a huddle, trying to figure out another plan. Now, who's everyone else?
What do you mean, everyone else? The Gospel of Luke doesn't mention anyone else.
Well, we know the stable is near an inn, and the inn was probably full of Jews who have been accompanied by Rome to register for a census. Why? So Rome knows how to tax the next year. How do you think they're feeling?
Well, we don't have any more actors.
You don't need actors. Scrap your stage crew. Great. Improvise. Better. Let's put it all together and see how it looks.
Yeah.
This isn't peace. This is chaos.
Exactly.
Okay, maybe I wasn't clear. This year's pageant is called Prince of Peace. This is not peaceful.
With all due respect, the Prince of Peace didn't come into a world that was peaceful. He came to bring peace to a world that was sinful, violent, and on enemy terms with God. A world that desperately needed
peace. He came to our chaos to be our Prince of Peace. I like it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Let's take five, guys.
Now, if you really want to be authentic, we should talk about the smell.
The smell?
Jesus was born in a stable after all.
I think I might have to draw the line right there.
Oh my.
Don't cry, your snowman, not in front of me. Who'll get your tears if you can't catch me, darling? If you can't catch me, darling. Don't cry, your snowman, don't leave me this way. A puddle of water can't hold me close, baby. Can't hold me close, baby. I want you to know.
Guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees the buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. In my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer.
Start going to all the places you could have left it. Is it in your coat? Is it on the dresser? Or maybe it fell out of your pocket on the driveway. Sometimes we find these things quickly, but other times we have to look extra long and hard to find them.
Okay, ma'am, let's think through this again. You said your son was with you while you were trying to close the window section?
Yes, he was right here playing on this iPad. I could tell he was getting anxious with the noise and crowd and all. He's not like a lot of other kids. He's got some challenges that make it hard for him to be out here. Oh, I know I shouldn't be running around here. This is too much.
Don't worry, ma'am. We'll find your son. I need a manager to Section 8. We have a possible missing child.
Sports. You love sports. Maybe you need us with the sporting goods.
That's a great idea.
But where are the sporting goods? I don't know how to find them. I'll take you there.
Sometimes we lose small things, like a car, like the car keys or a cell phone or even the TV remote. These things seem so small, but in the moment, the whole world stops till you can find them. But have you ever lost someone? I don't mean lost as in they're dead, although that's definitely a loss. And I don't mean lost as in they're lost wandering the woods. I mean lost as in they're there, but they're not actually with you.
Ma'am, I promise we're going to find your son. We've got all our associates in high alert.
What about a food court or a restaurant? He was complaining that he was hungry right before. Maybe he found his way there. We have a cafe on the second floor. Can you please take me there? Of course.
Jesus once told a parable about a lost coin. In the parable, a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one of them. Jesus says that the woman turns on all the lights in her house and flips her house upside down looking for that coin. There's nothing she wouldn't do to find that coin. My grandma used to tell me that parable and say, remember, the coin wasn't lost because it no longer is in the house or it no longer belonged to the woman. It was lost because it was no longer with her. It was lost in plain sight. She'd always say there was more than one way to be lost. You could be lost pursuing a career. You could be lost chasing a relationship. You could be lost trying to please other people. And we're all born lost from the Father, but you're never too lost for God. He can save you no matter what kind of lost you are.
Does your son have a habit of running away?
No, I mean, yes. I mean, I try not to take him out to places that would stress him out too much. He's very distressing to people, especially grown-ups.
Attention, associates. If you find the little boy, please proceed with caution. He's easily spooked. Let's go to my office and call the police.
You know, one of the beautiful things about Christmas is that it reminds us, no matter how lost we may feel, God is looking for us, calling for us, bidding us to find our place by his side. And we're all... Christmas is a story on how Jesus left all the splendor and glory of heaven to seek and to save all who were lost. Could he have done this without coming into the flesh? I don't know, but what I do know is that he chose to become as a human. He chose to walk among us, to get down on our level. That's what makes Christmas such a beautiful rescue story.
God, another lawsuit.
Suppose a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one of them. Doesn't she light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully till she finds it? And when she does find it, doesn't she call over all of her friends and neighbors and say, rejoice with me, for I found my lost coin. In the same way, I tell you, there is rejoicing over the angels of God over one sinner who repents.
Thank goodness.
This isn't rare. This is the third one this month.
Okay, thank you so much.
You.
This is the only world we know, and for now this rental's our home. If we gon' be a reflection, gotta make this stern rock glow. Just so you know.
Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, Jesus, music for the people.
In the city might be more than pretty pretty. That freaky shine might be more than meets the eye. Anytime you see the sparkle in the dark, you might look deeper, deeper. It might be more than simply theater. Yo, that smile might be joy that's connected to the spirit. The spirit might be contagious. If you dare, you dare come near it. I remember, can't forget. Peace that you can't second guess. Sparkle as the light reflects. We write and pay it forward checks.
Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, Jesus, music for the people.
Day.
Really?
Well, we only have a few minutes for the story, so better get on with it, eh?
All right. Thank you, Mr. Scrooge. God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Then Mr. Scrooge closes up shop and heads home. As Scrooge is settling in for the night, he begins to hear noises in his home.
Things that go bump in the night.
Ooh! What? What is this? Who's that? Hello. Marley. My old business partner. How is it you're here? Unless you're a ghost.
Yes, I am a ghost.
Oh, I say dead people.
And I've come to give you warning, Ebenezer. You will be visited this night by three ghosts. The ghost of Christmas past, the ghost of Christmas present, and the ghost of Christmas future.
But I'm afraid of ghosts. I don't want to be visited by them. Why is this happening?
Because, Ebby, you're a mean old man, and nobody likes you. And I don't want you to end up like me, suffering for eternity, eternity.
But Molly, you were a good man, a good businessman.
Maybe so, but my business should have been mankind.
No, you're just a figment of my imagination. Something I ate, that burrito I had from lunch at Taco Bell.
Oh, I can assure you, it's real.
No, get away from me, spirit!
So the spirit disappears in Scrooge, but leaving here suffered a terrible hallucination from suspicious food, falls asleep in his bed, only to be awakened later that night.
Scrooge. Scrooge!
What? What, who's that?
Scrooge, it is I, the ghost of Christmas past.
No?
Yes.
No, not possible. If I can't see you, you're not there.
What are you, four? Open your eyes, let's get on with it.
Where are we?
Open your eyes. This is the past, your past, Ebenezer. This is your...
My boyhood home. Yes, I remember well that child.
Is you, Ebenezer, abandoned and all alone.
His father is angry with him, and his mother is dead. His mother died in childbirth, so his father sent him away to this school.
Yes, Ebenezer, your childhood wasn't all that great.
But I grew up into a young man, and I met a young woman. Her name is Belle, which means beautiful.
Yes, we know. You fell in love with Belle, and she loved you back.
It was the happiest time of my life. I wanted to marry her, but I needed to make my fortune.
And while you were off making your fortune, Belle got bored. So much for love.
But I became rich!
Congratulations.
What's happened to Belle?
She's blissfully happy, unlike you. And so ends the past portion of this haunting. Now I must leave you.
And now it's my turn. I'm the ghost of Christmas present. Let's go see what everyone's doing right now.
Oh, spirit, I'm quite tired. I'd really like to just take a small nap.
No nap on your feet. You can sleep when you're dead. It will be soon enough.
What was that?
Never mind. The ghost of Christmas future will tell you all about it.
His name is Cecil.
We are now at the home of your employee, Bob Cratchit, and this is his son, Tiny Tim.
God bless us, everyone.
Tim is very sick and not likely to live much longer.
Father, will there be any supper for Christmas?
Oh yes, Tim. The finest goose you've ever seen.
But that's not much of a goose.
Curious, since you pay him so well.
Father, will there be any Christmas presents?
We have each other. That's all the Christmas we need. Here's a toast to Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge? That old miser? I like to give him a punch in the...
God bless us, everyone.
Now, dearest, we mustn't speak ill of Mr. Scrooge. It is Christmas, after all. To Mr. Scrooge.
To Mr. Scrooge.
God bless us,
get it, Tim.
Spirit, this is too much. Too painful, that poor child.
But don't you see, Scrooge? You're Lord upon this. This is your doing.
No. Get away from me, Spirit. Haunt me no more. Haunt me no more. This is too much for just one night.
Cecil, the ghost of Christmas future. Please, sir, I've had enough. Please move on. What is it you want to show me so I can end this nightmare?
No, it can't be! I don't want to die. I don't want to end up like Mom. I don't want to miss Christmas. I don't want to miss the season finale of The Bachelor. Wait, I'm awake.
Scrooge was so excited that his visits would go forever. He ran at the window and said,
"You there, boy, what day is it?"
It's Christmas Day, sir.
Why, of course. Duh. Run to the market and buy the prize turkey in the window. And Merry Christmas.
So Ebenezer Scrooge bought the prize turkey in the window and had it delivered to the Clutch's house. And not only did he provide them with enough food for a feast, he also doubled Bob's salary and made sure Tiny Tim would live.
God bless us, everyone.
What a gift to be given.
A second chance.
A chance to change, to make things different.
Just like new fallen snow that makes everything new and clean, our Heavenly Father grants us with a chance to empty our lives of bitterness and regret.
Redemption.
Grace. Mercy.
Themes that are widely accepted over the Christmas season, whether you're a church-going believer or not. Everyone is looking for a second chance.
A do-over.
I wish I'd been better with my money.
I wish I had said that to my mom.
I wish I had cheated on my test.
I wish I had lost my temper.
But thankfully, we serve the one God who gives second chances.
We serve a God who specializes in grace.
Who made a way for all of us to have a second chance at redemption.
In the Bible, the Old Testament tells us over and over how the world was so messed up and how badly people behaved towards each other and towards God.
A price had to be paid for our sins. We were in desperate need of saving, and then God made a way.
In the form of a tiny baby who grew up to be our Savior and take away our sins, He gave us all a second chance.
For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
God bless us, everyone.
Thank you. jingle bells jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride. Oh, what fun it is to ride. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
announcing the arrival of the very first Christmas Express special in Mount Kansas City, Wichita, and Parts East, arriving on track one.
What is that contraption you've got there, ma'am?
This chair? Sure do. I've come into Incarnation to document your Christmas celebration. Thank goodness for the train. Hey, can I get a picture of you? Say cheese.
Cheese.
Sure. Anything about what's happening today? Bother you?
Why would it?
Of the criminal element coming in on the train.
Stranger, outside, bandit.
I am here along some strangers loose.
Now just hold your horses. Last thing I need are you three getting all worked up about something that ain't never gonna happen.
What is it, Dutch?
Don't got time to talk. I've got too much going on already. I'm bringing out my new school Marvin Quadrant.
She's on this train?
Sure is. And there she is. It sure is good to meet you in person, Miss Paula.
And it's certainly good to meet you, Sheriff Laramie. I've learned so much by your wonderful, very meaningful princess, your incarnation. So it's been quaint. I'm so excited.
Well, you can't be half as excited as we are to have it. Sally is our postmaster. I'm sure she'd be glad to help you get your things.
Sure thing, Sheriff. Come on, Miss Paula, follow me.
You see, that's what I was afraid of.
What?
Clear out your wax. Did you hear her say quaint?
Sure did. What's quaint mean?
It means charming, old-fashioned. Miss Polly's from the big city, Wichita Falls. The big time? We're just small taters to her.
We're not small taters. Got that new bandstand town square.
It's not a bandstand. It's called a gazebo.
We got to come up with an idea that'll impress everyone this Christmas.
I've got it, it's the best one yet.
generations of war. But now that other people in our town, we didn't need to change things. Can't we just be ourselves?
She's got a point, Phyllis.
Sad. I'm voting for Chairman of Incarnation Christmas Committee, but let me explain. These people are used to bigger things than we got. We don't want to seem small and get laughed at.
There's nothing small about the creator of the world becoming a man. After all, that's what the name of our town means. God becoming a man. I'd say that's a funny thing.
Thanks for your thoughts, Sally, but I believe we done this, Adam.
Well, that's one problem solved. But what are we gonna do about Bandit?
Mrs. Sneak is right, y'all. For all we know, that train is fixing to bring a heck of trouble to Incarnation. My robber story. Or my blacksmith shop.
Hey, Evan. Now, you realize Joey has a long tail cat and a room full of rocking chairs.
You should be nervous yourself, Sheriff. I hear lonesome strangers visiting these parts.
I can't have all three of you wrapped up trying to find the Bandit blood. Don't even. Wait, no, I got it. I've got a secret and dangerous mission for you all, Liz.
What is it? Don't tell me.
I am deputizing the three of you as our posse to apprehend that sidewinder of a lonesome stranger if he tries to get into Incarnation.
You will regret this, Sheriff.
You won't fail me, Sheriff.
It is all but I provide Incarnation. You have the most wonderful Christmas decorations. But I want to add that a very special piece for the Christmas Eve service. And it's coming all in Dodge City.
What is that? What is it?
It's a very special manger, made by my great-great-great-grandfather, and passed through generations in the family.
Well, it ain't no electric light. I can tell you that right now.
This manger's over 200 years old, Sheriff. It's the oldest Christmas decoration in the West. And this year, it'll be right in time Incarnation.
Very nice.
Very old. I still say this Christmas, we need something modern.
I think this Christmas, we need more of what people always need. More hope, more love, more joy.
Sally's right. That's why God sent Jesus. We don't have to come here.
And that's why we need all the joy.
and a black overcoat.
Dickie, I think I saw that onward of the Avenue train the other day. Big black hats, wide grin, blue mustache, and wear a long black coat.
Okay, y'all, better keep an eye out. Now, I don't want the town panicking, so we're just going to keep it between us, okay?
Excuse me, everyone. We'd like to have your attention. As we all know, Christmas is 2 weeks away, and this year is the 150th anniversary of Handel's famous piece, The Messiah. We are working very hard on the version of the holiday chorus from that one's will work.
Oh, good. Now that we've gone from 200 years ago to 150, at least we're going in the right direction.
I think my father Parsworth was here to see this. He is pastor of God's new church. Until last year, when he went to a better place.
My daddy wants me to be here today, but obviously, God had other plans.
Well, we're ready for our first performance, and all we need is just a musical accompaniment.
Well, Miss Polly, we're just simple folk, not like the professionals we booked back in the East. We got no violins or harpsichord or harpsy, harpa, trumpet.
after a lonely stranger, it's time to see what you look like.
Since then, we're the outsiders, we're the outlaws.
Just wait, and then Sam Hill is going on here.
It may be the lonesome stranger's gang, Sheriff. Posse caught these yellow bellies trying to sneak off the train. Can I get a capture of the lonesome stranger's gang?
But God had a
that this would be the perfect time to start the nativity pageant?
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And this shall be a sign unto you: ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God, and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
We will have life everlasting.
Loaned Manger? Well, even though the Parson almost got mistaken for the lonesome stranger and tossed him a pony, it turns out he fell in love with Incarnation and settled here for good. I guess you can say the Loaned Manger became our own. The Loaned Manger ain't loaned no more. And if I ain't mistaken, that would be the last train to Incarnation tonight, bringing friends, family, worshipers, and loved ones. But I'm getting ahead of myself. The good folks of Incarnation still have some celebrating to do. We have a